Of water, we got a fair amount of that today. Chief Meteorologist Kristen Van Dyke is here with
We
what
sure
it did.
have. Yeah, the rainiest day of November, but you head up to the resorts
Oh,
and
it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Yep. I'll let
Sing
you
it,
finish
Jeff.
That one out. Yeah, look at this. Just beautiful earlier this morning, and there's a lot more to come. In fact, remember how I was talking about the temperatures here jumping up by 10 degrees or more?
What,
yeah.
Like from what, 4 to 5 we jumped
it
up
went
10
from
degrees?
43 to 55. Just
wow.
within like an hour and a
10
half.
10 degrees
or so.
In
yes.
1 hour?
Yeah, yes. So it was pretty amazing. But that happened at the resort. So we started off really good. It kind of changed over to rain, but we're going to change it back over to snow tonight. And we are going to add up those totals. Wait until you see how much we're going to be looking at for the ski resorts this weekend. It's exciting news, especially because it means that it looks like it'll be a go to get those resorts open for the holiday weekend next week. In fact, Mount Bachelor is planning on opening on a limited availability for Monday because they've picked up so much snow and they're going to get the snow too. Meanwhile, we get the rain. It continues to pour. 55 degrees. Winds coming in from the south at 18. We did have a gust up near 30, 35 miles an hour earlier, just the last hour, really. And you can see where the heavier stuff's trying to push back into Portland. So we can't just get rid of this rain yet, but we will start to see at least breaks between the showers for tomorrow. So it won't be an all-day event like we've seen today. We've already picked up half an inch, and we could pick up another half an inch as we head to the overnight hours, a wider view. You can see showers pushing up on up into the Cascades, back toward McMinnville, Tillamook, down toward Lincoln City, up near Astoria, getting the rain and getting pounded by the wind. We've had winds between 70 and 80 miles an hour across parts of the coastal areas. Wind gusts now starting to calm down a little bit. Newport, though, up to 45 mile an hour winds. High wind warnings in effect through 7 p.m. tonight, and then that goes away, but still very breezy for you tomorrow. Winds gusting along the Willamette Valley, and we have been calm until that front came through. It moved our temperatures up, and now we're seeing those gusts up near 33 miles an hour. Take a look at the snow level. So it was lower this morning. It shot all the way up to over 7,000 feet today. Tonight, though, it dips back down to 3,500 feet, and that's going to mean snow at pass level, and it could get pretty dicey on those roads as we're going to be able to pick up at 3,000 feet, 3,500 feet, about 5, perhaps 10 inches of snow. Winter weather advisors up and down the Cascades for that. It goes until 9 p.m. tomorrow. Here's a look at Bend downtown. Remember when it was all snow covered for so long? We finally warmed things up there, so the road's not looking as bad. Mount Hood snowcast, 4 to 8 inches for Government Camp and Ski Bowl by Sunday, 8 to 14 inches or more for Timberline Lodge and Mount Hood Meadows as we wrap up this weekend. It's going to be a good one for the ski resorts. Rain and cloud forecast for us. We still get the rain as we head to the overnight hours. 1:30 a.m. We still may be occasionally seeing some of the moderate rain, and then we start to see the rain change over into snow dropping as we head through the overnight hours. Tomorrow morning, waking up to snow across the Cascades, and then just spotty shower activity for us, but we still could pick up a heavy shower here and there. So tomorrow will be wet, but keep an eye on the PDX weather app, and you can take a look at the radar and kind of figure out when it's safe to go out if you don't want to be out in the rain. That's what I do when I go to the dog parks. It's a really good app for that. Low to mid 50s for tomorrow afternoon. Wet at times, staying very windy. Winds gusting at 30 miles an hour, but occasionally seeing some of those higher gusts through the day. I-5. Temperatures in the low 50s, wet at times, and then central and eastern Oregon, we're looking at temperatures in the upper 30s and low 40s with rain and higher elevation snow. Cascades, 5 to 10 inches by Saturday night, and those passes through the Cascades will be pretty yucky through the weekend. A 7-day forecast. We start to dry out a little bit next week. We warm things up too, and Thanksgiving right now doesn't like a washout, but there is that slight chance for rain.
Slight chance of rain. And with all this rain we had, Ann and I were looking at all our monitors around. Traffic is just a mess tonight.
Yeah, it is.
And, you know, we had so much rain, and I think it kind of flooded some of the roads. It's awful out there.
It is
drive
really
careful.
Mm-hmm.
And coming.